Chapter Abduction Legislation Miscellaneous Amendment Bill 2013. Committee stage. Council is now in committee. Members may refer to Appendix 1 to the script for the debate and voting arrangements for the bill. I will first deal with the clauses with no amendment. I now propose a question to you, and that is that the following clauses stand part of the Child Abduction Legislation Miscellaneous Amendments Bill 2013. Clauses 1, 2, 7, 8, and 10 to 17. Does any member wish to speak? I now put the question to you, and that is that clauses 1, 2, 7, 8, and 10 to 17 stand part of the bill. Will those in favour please raise their hands? Mr. Alpacham claims a division. The division bell will ring for 5 minutes. Voting begins. Please check your votes. Voting is closed. The results are displayed. 38 present, 37 for, none against, none abstained. I think the question is agreed by a majority of the members present. I declare the motion passed. Mr. Chen Kam Lam. Deputy, I move that in the event of further divisions being claimed on the child abduction legislation MA Bill 2013, the division bell may ring for only 1 minute. I now propose a question to you, and that is that the motion moved by Mr. Chen Kam Lam be passed. Does any member wish to speak? I now put the question to you as stated. Would those in favour please raise their hands? Those against please raise their hands. I think the question is agreed by a majority of the members present. I declare the motion passed. I order that in the event of further divisions being claimed on the Child Abduction Legislation, Miscellaneous Amendments Bill 2013 and the CSAs, the voting should proceed after the bell has rung for 1 minute. Clauses 3 to 6, 9 and 18, Secretary for Labour and Welfare. Chairman, I move the amendments to clauses 3, 4, 6, 9 and 18 and the deletion of clause 5. The amendments have been circulated to members. The major amendments are as follows. First of all, the Law Reform Commission proposes that the Family Court be empowered to order, to grant provision orders under the CECL. Now we have sought advice from the judiciary. According to the judiciary, CECL is currently under the exclusive jurisdiction of the Court of First Instance. According to the bill, Hague Convention cases can only be dealt with by the CFI. If the power is extended to the district court to make prohibition orders under CECL, it would cause confusion to the legally qualified and lay court users. Therefore, we, in order to address the judiciary's concern, would like to divide the bill into three parts. To clarify, the provisions giving effect to the Hague Convention and other provisions to cover cases not concerned with the operation of the Hague Convention. That is part A. Part 1 is the preliminary and being interpretations. Part 2 is provisions giving effect to the Hague Convention. And Part 3 is other provisions combating child abduction in Hong Kong, including new provisions not concerning the operation of the Hague Convention. And both the CFI and the District Court will have jurisdictions for matters contained in Part 3. We have consulted the judiciary on the above recommendations, and they agree that the three-part structure of CECL can provide better clarity. Now, having divided the CECL to divide the CECL into three parts, we will make corresponding amendments to the bill. First of all, we propose to add Section 4.2 to the bill, to add the definitions of immigration officers, district court, and authorized officer in CECL, and also to delete the definition for stop order, that is the recovery order for cases of parental child abduction covered by Hague Convention, and also the definition for prohibition order, that is to prevent removal of child out of Hong Kong without consent of parents. And we also propose to amend the relevant provisions in Clause 9. For example, in relation to the legal proceedings concerning access or custody of children, the use of applicable information under the location order, or the use of such information which may be detrimental to the child. To address members' concerns, Based on the LRC's recommendation, we'd like to add Section 16.2A so that the court can stipulate in the location order the applicable information can only be used in the relevant proceeding for the return of a child under the Hague Convention that have commenced or about to commence in Hong Kong or in another contracting state. And when there are major changes in circumstances, the Secretary for Justice may wish to empower, may wish the court to alter, vary, or revoke the proposed order under KECO. And to based on this situation, we would like to add Section 18.3A of the in KECO to stipulate that the CFI may specify to or to vary suspend or discharge order made under KECO. However, the new 18.3B will not affect the powers or discretionary powers made by the CFI apart from this provision. And in the gazetted version of the bill, we will add a Section 18A to empower the CFI to require a recovery order for the return of the child. And in the gazetted version of the bill, it contains Section 18 of the KECO, and we propose to renumber and add Section 18A. We propose to delete the term stop order in Section 8, Section 19 of the gazetted version of the bill. Stop order also covers recovery orders in the Hague Convention cases and other prohibition orders applicable to non-Hague Convention cases. And we propose to set the relevant procedures concerning recovery and prohibition orders in the new Part 2 and Part 3 of KECO. And for Part E, and also Section 20 in the gazetted version of the bill. We are going to include new 19A, and this will go for 20A as well, because this is a consequential amendment to the restructuring of the bill into three parts. The new 20A empowers immigration officers and policemen to detain a child if they have reasonable suspicion that a child has been or is being removed from Hong Kong in contravention to a recovery order issued by the immigration director. And that detained child should be sent to a place of safety as soon as reasonably practicable, so that the child can stay there until he or she can be passed on to a specified person as stated in the recovery order. If this is not possible, the DSW will have to take appropriate action. As for the other amendments, they are for textual purposes and also to move the provisions around, and many of them are consequential amendments. Mr. Chairman, all these amendments have been the subject of detailed discussion and have been supported by the Bills Committee. I urge members to support the amendments. Thank you. Does any member wish to speak? I now put the question to you, and that is that the amendments moved by the Secretary for Labour and Welfare be passed. Will those in favour please raise their hands? Mr. Albert Chan claims a division. The bell will ring for 1 minute.
現在付諸表決。
Voting begins. Please check your vote. Voting is closed. Please display the results. 35 present, 34 for, no against, no abstention. I think the question is agreed by a majority of the members present. I declare the amendments passed. As the amendment to delete Clause 5 has been proposed by the committee, Clause 5 is deleted from the bill. Clauses 3, 4, 6, 9, and 18 as amended. I now put the question to you, and that is that Clauses 3, 4, 6, 9, and 18 as amended stand part of the bill. Would those in favour please raise their hands? Mr. Raymond Chen claims a division. The division bell will ring for 1 minute.
Wong Kwok-kin 議員。
Mr. Wong Kwok-kin, your phone has rung many times, and if you don't switch it off, I'll have to order you to leave this chamber.
現在開始表決。
Voting begins.
請各位核對。
Members, please check your votes. If there are no queries, voting is closed. The results are displayed. 35 present, 34 yes.No noes, no abstentions. The question is agreed by a majority of the members present. New Clause 3A, Part 1, Heading Added. New Clause 4A, Part 2, Heading Added. New Clause 4B, Section 3, Amended. Convention to have force of law in Hong Kong. New Clause 4C, Section 4, Amended. Contracting States. New Clause 8A.Section 12, Amended Rules of Court. New Clause 9A, Part 3, Added. Secretary for Labour and Welfare. President, I move the second reading of new clauses 3A, 4A, 4B, 4C, 8A, and 9A. As I have already explained, we propose to divide the bill into three parts. The first part, introduction, the second part, implementation of the Hague Convention, and the third part, other provisions to combat abduction of children in Hong Kong. And we have proposed the bill to add 3A, 4A, 4B, 4C, and 9A. With regard to the location order and the recovery order in Part 2 of the ordinance, these are within the jurisdiction of the CFI. And so we propose to add 8A.So that there will be a rules committee to make rules of court for giving effect to this part, as appears to the committee to be necessary or expedient. And then concerning, after careful consideration by the Bills Committee and having consulted the DOJ, there will be a new 9A to include the title to Part 3, and there will also be other amendments. First of all, there will be concerning Section 15 has appeared in the Gazette, there will be a new Clause 22 so that a personmust not remove the child out of Hong Kong without the consent of the following persons, whether or not a parent of the child. And if the court order is in force, or if proceedings concerning the custody of or access to the child are pending in a court. And we are also proposing to add to Section 22 of the ordinance that with regard to the new 22 bracket 4, the court that made the order may...vary or discharge the order or suspend the operation of a provision of the order and revive the operation of the provision so suspended. And if the court needs to vary suspend or discharge the order, then this provision will apply. But then the new 22.5.States clearly that subsection 4 does not affect the powers and discretions of the court that are exercisable apart from that subsection. And then 22.8, we have the definition of children or child. This is in relation to a court order made by the court of first instance in exercise of its jurisdiction relating to a ward of court under Section 26 of the High Court Ordinance kept for or any proceedings related to exercise of the jurisdiction. And means the infant who is the subject of that order of those proceedings. And of course, there are cross-references to other ordinances, including the Guardianship of Minors Ordinance. We want to make sure that the definitions of child in the various ordinances will remain consistent. And concerning prohibition orders, they can be made by the CFI and the district courts under the ordinance. And in order to clarify the situation, we propose to add 22.8 in 22.8 the definition of court concern, and also under what circumstances CFI or the district court can issue prohibition orders. And concerning the three parts of the ordinance, we have section 19 as the version as gazetted and there is this new section 23. It says that or the original version says that once an application has been made to the court of first instance on a prohibition order, or if the court has already issued a prohibition order, then the father or mother who has made the application can inform the immigration department so that no one can take remove the children out of Hong Kong without suitable consent or approval. We've considered the Bills Committee's views, and we've also made reference to court procedures, and we are proposing that some changes to the new Section 23. And the protection will apply to applicants who have the genuine intent to present the case to the court for a hearing. The bill includes, or in the gazetted version, includes section 20, and we now have this new section 24. It is about giving powers to police officers or immigration officers to bring the children to a safe place under practicable circumstances. And then under Section 24.5, it is said that the SWD or the Director of Social Welfare will have suitable powers to take follow-up action. And concerning the new Section new Clause 25, this is for the for a Rules Committee to be set up under Section 55 of the High Court Ordinance or Section 17 of the District Court Ordinance. These provisions, in fact, have been supported by the Bills Committee, and we hope that members will all support these provisions. I now put the question to you, propose the question to you, and that is that new clauses 3A4, A4B, 4C, 8A, and 9A be read the second time. Does any member wish to speak? I now put a question to you, and that is that new clauses 3A, 4A, 4B, 4C, 8A, and 9A be read a second time. Those in favour, please raise their hands. Those against. Mr. Edward Chang claims a division. The bell will ring for 1 minute.
Voting
begins.
请各位核对。
Please check the votes.
没问题的。
If there are no questions, voting is closed. Clerk, please display the results. 36 present, 35 for, no against, no abstention. I declare the motion passed. New clauses 3A, 4A, 4B, 4C, 8A, and 9A. Secretary for Labour and Welfare. Chairman, I move that new clauses 3A, 4A, 4B, 4C, 8A, and 9A be added to the bill. I now propose the question to you, and that is that new clauses 3A, 4A, 4B, 4C, 8A, and 9A be added to the bill. I now put the question to you as stated. Will those in favour please raise their hands? Mr. Raymond Chen claims the division. The bell will ring for 1 minute. Voting begins. Please check your votes. If there are no questions, voting is closed and the results will be displayed. 38 present, 37 for, no objection, no abstention. I think the question is agreed by majority of the members present. I declare the motion passed. Council now resumes third reading, child abduction legislation.